Okay, Ocean State Running here, powered by Marathon Sports, sponsored by Hoka. We are here at the RIIL State Outdoor State Cross Country Championships. It feels like outdoor. And what a meet we have. We have the girls and the boys race. Both can be close. Both can be close in individual and team-wise. So here alongside me is Nessa Malloy, Wheeler coach, and my social media director.
I got a raise this week.
I always say guru. I'm going to say director. Right. Let's talk about this race. The individual race, you have Rory Sullivan, you have Aaron Von Huisen, and you have Keeney Behe. These are the three that can win today. I don't think anybody can challenge them. I think, unless we get a real surprise here, but I think those are the three we got to focus on.
Yeah, 100%. And I mean, we've had state meets in the past where we've had crazy surprise winners. But all season, these three have risen to the top and have put the times down to prove that there are no flash in the pan. So I definitely think, yeah, they're going to be the ones we see leading at the mile, and then we'll see when they come out of those woods what happens.
Yeah, and speaking of leading, who do you think is going to take the lead in this race? I think they're going to probably all run together, basically. I don't know. Maybe we'll see Rory go out and, you know, she ran 5:37 last week.
Rory said last week as well that when she was coming to the mile and she saw the time, she was like, whoa, this is too slow. And we were already seeing how crazy fast it was. So it lets us know she's ready to take it out, you know?
And that's what I expect. I think Rory's going to be up there. Like I said, Keeney Behe has been red hot, and, you know, Aaron Von Huisen, they're all capable of running a time. I think, you know, last week, Rory did, what, 1830?
Yeah.
Or 1830. I think all of them can go under 830 today.
Yeah.
It's absolutely perfect conditions. No sun. It's cool. It's perfect.
The unusual thing about the three of them is none of them have a team championship on the line, so they're free of that pressure.
Absolutely.
Which is kind of unusual. Usually,
On the subject of team, last week, LaSalle beating Cumberland, it was considered an upset. Normally, you wouldn't say that with a LaSalle team, but LaSalle came up big and beat Cumberland. I think you're going to see those two teams, but you can't ignore North Kingstown.
Yeah. And like you put in your article, they had one of their top scorer, one of their top five, didn't race last week.
Yeah, and I don't know if she's here, but they do have, if she is in this race, then it could be tough. And that runner Hallie Pomeranz.
Yeah.
So Hallie.
And after the meet merge last week, if you looked at it, it was close when you put all the classes together. So, it's so exciting that we don't have a clear favorite. That's what I'm so excited about today. I'm rooting for every kid here, but this makes for an exciting statement when there's no runaway.
Thing is, this is going to be an extremely exciting race, and it's going to be the perfect kickoff to the boys' race, which is going to be insane, too.
Yeah.
We've got Hendrickson and Cumberland. Those are the teams that are going to be battling for that team title. And you have a host of guys battling for the individual title. But it looks like we're going to have the start of the girls' race anytime soon.
They're doing their call-outs. I love that they do this at the state meet. You give every team and the individuals a chance to run out with their team and get a cheer and get some attention. And, of course, as always, Paunagansett have done an amazing job with this course, setting it up. It is beautiful. The weather was perfect all week. We don't have any straw. Usually on this corner,
Absolutely. We
have a pile up of people when they get stuck in the mud, but it is perfect.
And talk about this part of the race right before the start. You know, obviously the nerves are very high, but they're also pretty high with the coaches. I mean, you were a coach here. How does that feel?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just looking at the master himself of commentary himself coming over. Welcome, Danny Brennan.
How's it going, everyone? Great race of the day. We have here girls, unbelievable. We have an unbelievable team battle between Cumberland, North Kingstown, and LaSalle Rams, Class A champs. We have an unbelievable individual battle. You know, I'm sure that Steve and Vanessa already talked about it. You know, Aaron Von Huisen, Rory Sullivan, and of course, Keeney Behe. How could I ever forget Keeney Behe, the pride of Warwick? So it's going to be great. You know, it's one of those things someone said to me earlier, This is a state meet where we don't know who the boys individual champion, boys team champion, girls team champion, or girls individual champion is going to be. So it's really exciting today. Four big titles on the line. Can't wait to watch.
Yeah, absolutely. I think everything's up for grabs, individually and team-wise. So it does look like we're going to be starting pretty soon. I cannot see Keith. Oh, yes, there I see him. Or is that Varnum? Varnum's the starter here, Varnum Elliott.
All right, and I just started Instagram Live. I know people at home on the camera won't hear this till later, but we are going to be doing some live on their own.
And we are off to the start of the girls' race here of the state championship here at Ponagansett. Again, this is going to be a very, very exciting race, individually and team-wise. And that's Abby Ty there, a freshman in the lead. Rory Sullivan right behind. I see Allie. I see Keeney Behe. Is that
Aaron is right there. Everybody.
Yep. All the major players are right there up in the first 200 meters. Aaron, Keeney Behe, Allison Pankowitz from Tollgate. They are all there getting right into the mix of things. We have Nessa going Instagram Live right now. You guys will see this later on in the week. But she is going closer to the mark. But going into about 200 meters, and it's all the usual suspects that you would think. Abby Ty in the lead right now. Rory Sullivan about a meter back. Keeney Behe right on her. Kylie DeFusco. They are all very, very close. We have a watch on them, and they'll be coming through right about that soccer net is the unofficial 400-meter mark. Looks like Rory Sullivan has just taken the lead. Keeney Behe right with her. And those two are out at about 74 seconds for 400 meters into the race. Abby Ty in third, and Kylie DeFusco giving chase in fourth. So it'll be very interesting to see how these girls look throughout that first mile.
Yeah, I like that bold move by Abby Ty, you know, taking that lead right at the beginning. But again, North Kingstown's a team that can definitely do something here today.
All right, we got our lead bike coming through, and all the major players still there. Sullivan in the lead. Behe giving chase. DeFusco, Ty, Von Housen, Madeline O'Neill from Narragansett, Allison Pankowitz from Tollgate. Make up your top seven. Alyssa Parento from LaSalle, Emmy Belvin, Grace Doyle, a whole bound of others in that top 21. We got a great team battle going through about 600 meters.
Like I said, absolutely perfect weather to run today. I mean, no sun, nice and cool.
Yeah, today, nice overcast day, not like last week when we had to worry about the heat and humidity. Taking a look over on the trails, our leaders are about to be 800 meters through, and that's Rory Sullivan and Keeney Behe out in about 243 unofficially. It looks like the two of them with Kylie DeFusco giving chase entering into the fields. It looks like a three-lady race this far, but there is a lot of race left. There's a pack of three going through after them with Von Housen, O'Neill, and Ty coming up on the 1,000-meter mark. A great team battle, a great individual battle as they come up on 1,000 meters.
Yeah, and like you said, Kylie DeFusco in third place. I look at her as rebounding here this week. She ran 19:40 last week. I mean, it's a good time, but for her, you know, she's not probably happy with it, but I can see her running very well.
All right, let's go to the mile.
Okay, we're here at the mile mark. We're waiting for our leaders.
We can have Steve. We can hear Steve now.
We expect it to be the same, Rory Sullivan and Keeney Behe, but a few more.
Yeah, we'll see. You know, a lot can happen. You know, at the 1,000-meter mark, you know, the girls were close. There was a pack of three and then a little bit of a break, and then another pack of three, and then about a pack of 12.
Looks like we have
the lead bike is coming through on the watch right now. We're about 5:15 as we can see them through, and this looks like Rory Sullivan in the lead, a small gap. Then Keeney Behe right after her. We're about to head into the hills. big uphill, then big downhill. Rory Sullivan from St. Ray's, unofficially 5:37, just like last week, 5:38. Kini Behe, Kylie DeFusco, Aaron Von Housen, Maddie O'Neill in six, and Abby Ty in seven. Abby Ty is in six, actually. Allison Pankowitz, Grace Doyle, 5:51. Emmy Belvin, North Kingstown, two. LaSalle's one. Jessica, the real deal. Chantanese boys, we have LaSalle has two. Cumberland now racing for the team battle. Cumberland with three runners through. We have LaSalle with three.
We have LaSalle with three runners through.
East Branch with three through. And then it looks like Cumberland's four and five right now. North Kingstown looks like they have two and three through. It is going to be a great team battle on the girls' side. Looks like LaSalle's four coming through. North Kingstown's six and seven. LaSalle's five right here. It is a great battle on the watch. We are at 6:31. Unbelievable team battle and individual battle. It's going to be real interesting to see what happens in the woods between these girls entering into the loop and exiting out of the loop.
I tell you, Cumberland looked strong. I saw all their seven come across before I think anyone's fifth. I mean, unless I was I missed somebody, but they looked very strong.
Hi, Connor Murphy. Always Rhode Island. Great on Instagram.
Great to see.
Cool. Ellie Lawler, we have to talk to you about your triathlon. We're gonna set that up. You hold the course. Ellie Lawler still holds the course record.
Correct? Yep.
Yeah, 17, so what is it, 29?
Ellie Lawler, South Kingstown course record, 17:29 for girls. We're not going to come close to that.
No.
But I don't know. We can have, it seems a low 18-minute time is possible.
Especially Rory going with some competition, unlike last week.
Exactly.
Where she was completely
right,
with herself. You know, you got Keeney ready to rock and roll after the mile mark. With great distance right there, right behind her.
So I'll see you guys in a few minutes.
All right, this is Ocean State Running here at the RIL State Cross Country Championships. We have the girls' race coming down. Here comes our lead bike. It looks like it'll be a pretty close run in the individual battle and the team battle. Our leader looks to be Rory Sullivan. Yep, that's her. Leading just like she did in the Class A meet. Right behind her looks to be Kini Behe. And shortly followed by Aaron Von Housen and Kylie DeFusco. Sullivan was our top finisher at the class meet when the merge results with an 1830. And Behe wasn't far behind in 1843. And Von Housen was the winner of the Class B race. DeFusco looks really strong. She's the top runner for a really strong Cumberland team. There's Abby Teague out of North Kingstown and Grace Doyle out of Classical.
About 15 seconds behind the front.
Jessica Deal from Mount Hope and Pankowitz from Mount.
Little by little, keep climbing.
Here's LaSalle's first runner. Saints second and NK's second. Here's Cumberland's two and three. That's a very strong team by them. LaSalle's got two or three in by now. Saints have three. Here's another runner for LaSalle. Another one for Cumberland. That's four in for Cumberland right now. Two more for NK. And that's Cumberland's fifth. NK's got four in right now, but Cumberland's got a really strong five. Here's East Greenwich has at least four or five in by now. There's Cumberland six and seven. Cumberland is running really strong right now. Their pack running is what has benefited them all season. They lost just by a little bit at the Class A championships, but we think they have a really good shot here today. LaSalle won at Class A, and to win here today, they've got to repeat their performance and maybe run a little bit faster. Right around here is where all the points matter the most. But around here is where a lot of teams have their fourth, fifth, and sixth runner. So these, right around here is where a lot of these points will really, really matter and push some teams over the edge of qualifying for New England's. Top six teams here today go to New England's. So it's really important that everybody brings their A game here today. Didn't say this earlier, but we're at about a mile and a quarter into the race. Just after the first big uphill, this is about maybe a halfway through the long gradual downhill. A unique part about this course is the mile and a quarter and about two and a quarter or two and a half is in the same spot. So I'll just be flipping around my camera and catching the leaders come up this hill that they're going down right now. All right, we're about 12 minutes into the race. I'm here at about two and a quarter, two and a half miles into this race here today. It's perfect conditions. Nice, right around 55, 60 degrees. Here comes our lead bike. Right around here is where a lot of the moves are made in the race and things can really change up. But that looks to be the same leader as going down the hill. That's Rory Sullivan. She seems to have put even more padding onto her lead. She's improved just about every year. I think fifth place as a freshman, then third the following year, and second as a junior. And she's looking to finally win that state title today. The race is really close for second place between Keeney Behay and Aaron Von Housen. Both winners of their respective class meets.
Good job, girls!
And not far behind them is Kylie DeFusco. She ran really well at her Class A championships last week, but seems that she was looking towards the even more important state championship here today. Then we have NK's top runner with Abby Teague running next to Maddie O'Neill out of Narragansett. That's our top five. In sixth and seventh, that's Grace Doyle in sixth, Jessica Deal in seventh. Here's Saint's second runner, Boyce, I believe. There's Moses Brown's top runner. They're looking to qualify for New England's here today. And here's LaSalle's first, NK's second. Really mixing up that team battle. Our top three teams all have a couple runners in. Here's Cumberland's two and three, the first team to get three runners, but closely followed by LaSalle's third. That's Mia Bettez. She just committed to Bryan a few weeks ago. Followed right behind, that's LaSalle's fourth. And Saints third. Saints putting on a pretty good show here today. Hopefully looking to qualify for New England's. That's a fourth for Cumberland. Another for Moses Brown. Looks to be LaSalle's fourth or fifth. Here's another for NK. I haven't even mentioned East Greenwich has been running really well. They seem to have at least four in right now. That looks to be their fourth or fifth. Another for NK, and another for Cumberland. This is shaping up to be a really, really close team battle. One that we think could be in the single digits for those top three teams. A couple more for East Greenwich. A team maybe looking to screw up the plans of one of those top three teams, those top three teams that were all three came out of Class A. East Greenwich out of Class B looking to mix things up with them. With Reese Faze graduating last year, she now runs for Providence College. East Greenwich is really filling the void after having such a talented runner leave the program they're still running very strong here today and have been all season. So they're looking to show that they aren't a joke even without Reese Faze. Like I said earlier, this is on the uphill, maybe about 2 miles into the race. The way this course works is that after about a mile, they go down for about a half mile, and then they start climbing all the way back up to where they started. And this is about halfway through that climb, so these girls are really climbing really hard right now. Once you crest this hill, there's not a lot of real estate left. You got maybe 1,000 meters left to make your final move, so this is really important that you make up as much ground and hold off your competitors as much as you can on this uphill. Interesting thing about Cumberland is they haven't won a team state title in 42 years. So they're really looking to win one today. They have a really good shot. Last week, they ran really well at the class championships, but didn't have the lowest stick and relied mainly on their pack running. But DeFusco looks like she could crack the top five, maybe in even top three if she passes either Keeney or Aaron on the way up this hill. Things will shake up really well in the following minutes. It's about 1.25 on the way down, 2.25 on the way up.
Okay. Let's go, Farfa! Yeah, glad to go!
Janet, don't go!
Come on,
Janet!
Right up that hill. Come on, Eddie!
You got this, almost done!
Come on, kid!
Okay,
go for them.
Let's go, Purple!
Nice shot, Classical.
Good job, Classical. Nice hope. Right up this hill. Doing good.
Good job, good job.
Good job.
Good job, Pastor, right up that hill. Doing good. All right, Pilgrim. You do this hill, no problem. It's nice and relaxed.
Expecting our leader to come around the tennis courts with 500 to go, and it is Rory Sullivan who is leading from the start. She looks very strong, and yeah, it looks like she built up a lead.
Rory Sullivan absolutely in control of this race right now. Rory Sullivan hoping to be on the short list of girls who are four-time first-team All-Staters. First-team All-State throughout all 4 years. Erin Von Housen now making the turn in second place. And then we have Keeney Behe, the pride of Pilgrim right now, in third place. Top three that we thought were going to be there. But Kylie DeFusco right on Keeney's tail. The two of them are separated by about 5 seconds. So we will have an unbelievable finish. It looks like Rory is in control. In fifth place, Maddie O'Neill. Sixth place, Abby Ty, the freshman from North Kingstown.
And seventh,
and then we have, nope, that's not Grace Doyle. That is Jessica Deal from Mount Hope. And then Grace Doyle coming with her second great performance on Pontagansett in a week. Allison Pankowitz from Tollgate. Jay Champlin from Moses Brown charging hard. And it looks like Shandonese Boyce from St. Ray's and Emmy Belvin from Mount St. Charles. So all the top girls that we thought were going to be in the race, all making the turn right now in about our top 10. Very, very great finish, and we'll see what happens with the team battle, because we have North Kingstown second right there, Lucy Stowe making the turn. LaSalle's first, that is Alyssa Parento making the turn. And we have Cumberland's second and third. That is Rose Tuamusto and Charlie McHugh. So we will have a great team battle. We have LaSalle second, Mia Batez making the turn right now. And we have LaSalle's third, Jaden Donnelly. Cumberland's four, making the turn. LaSalle's four, making the turn.
Here comes down the stretch.
Rory Sullivan, first team All-State, all 4 years, state champion, unofficially 18-08. Unbelievable performance by Rory. Great job, Rory. Second place, runner-up Erin Von Housen from Cherahoe High School, unofficially in 18-18. And we have now third place in the state, Keeney Behe, unofficially right now, 18-27. And we have a great team battle coming right now. Cumberland's first. That's Kylie DeFusco in fourth place. Fifth place, Jessica Deal. Sixth place, Madeline O'Neill. Seventh place, Abby Ty from North Kingstown. A great, great team battle as we see starting to unfold in the field.
And Allie Kankowitz and Grace Doyle.
That's Jay Champlin from Moses Brown finishing. We have Emmy Belvin and Shandonini Boyce from St. Raphael also coming through. 19-10 and Shandonini Boyce 19-14 unofficially.
Who is winning this team title? It's hard to tell right now.
Very hard to tell because we have North Kingstown's number two.
And it looks like number three, or is that LaSalle?
That's LaSalle's first. North Kingstown's number two, that's Lucy Stowe, freshman. Two freshmen. LaSalle's number one, Alyssa Parento. Cumberland's number two right here. Portsmouth from soccer. Cumberland's number three. Cumberland with the first one in with three. LaSalle now with two in as well. East Greenwich just putting two in. Here we go. This is going to be a great battle. This is Cumberland's four, LaSalle's three, LaSalle's four. This is a great team battle on the girls' side. It's going to come down to the fifth runner. Maeve Casey from LaSalle. Great run for Maeve. We got Barrington, Westerly, Moses Brown's number two, East Greenwich's three, St. Ray's's number three, North Kingstown's number three. There's Cumberland's number five in the field.
I don't know. Could that have done it right here with Cumberland's five?
It's all going to depend on where LaSalle's five is.
Absolutely.
Scoring, it looks like this is going to be Cumberland six, possibly.
Keep working through the shoot. Keep working through the shoot.
Barrington with a couple, North with another one. Moses Brown silently. This looks like they're four or five.
LaSalle's number five, right?
Looks like LaSalle's five, unofficially 21-13. Unless we missed something, there was a lot happening early on in the race.
Yeah, unless we miss something, it does look like it could be a Cumberland victory.
Good job. All the way through. Keep walking through the chute. Through the chute. Through the chute. Good job. Good job, girls. Keep walking through the chute. Keep walking through the chute. Through the
What a race. The top three, just like we expected, Rory Sullivan, Aaron Von Heusen, and Keeney Behe getting those top three positions. Kylie DeFusco, Cumberland, coming back from last week, getting fourth place.
Great job, girl. Keep running.
Don't know the scores yet, but it does look like it's a possibility of Cumberland winning. I believe the last time they've won a state title has been 1981. So again, it does look like we are going to have a close battle in the team standings. But it does look like Cumberland, and again, this will be the first time in 42 years. If they pull out the win, it'll be the first time in 42 years that they've won a state title. Again, we're Ocean State Running and powered by Marathon Sports, sponsored by Hoka. And we're here at the RIIL State Cross Country Championships, the girls' race, and what a girls' race it was. Rory Sullivan winning the race unofficially. It looks like 18:06. Could be faster, but either way, a big PR for her. As well as a lot of the top finishers.